Justin, so when you have some lower back pain, some tightness along the posterior chain, the hamstrings, and the glutes, there's a lot you can do with these tennis balls. So we're going to find a few places you can put the tennis balls and then a few stretches to complement the tennis ball exercises. So starting with, if you could turn to the side for me, your spinal erectors, that's going to be on either side of your spine on your lower back. Then we're going to move down to either side of your sacrum, so that's like the top line of your glutes, piriformis right in the middle of your glutes, and then down to the hamstrings. We'll show you how to get into positions to put the tennis ball in an effective place. So if you can go ahead and get onto your back and bring your shins up. If you can get on that side, that would be great. Now bring your shins up onto the box. This way we've got a flat spine. There's no extension happening in the spine. Nice happy back. And then lift up your side leg. Please slide this in under here, either side of your spine. Find a good tender place. And kind of lift your right hip up, shift your weight over to your left. Find some tenderness, you can roll around there. Got something?
Got it.
Okay, cool. So you'll take each of these exercises for just about a minute. That's the first place. After you hit your spinal erectors and you've been there for about a minute, just kind of circling around any places where there's tension, leaning some weight into the places where there's resistance, and take your tennis ball and move it down to your waistline. Outside of the backs of your pelvic bones, so where you feel that little bone in your spine, move it right to the outside of that. Got it? Whole top line of the glutes, same thing there, just sort of massaging. It's all self-massage, so you're just using that ball to try to hit your trigger points all along the top line of the glutes. You can move it further out laterally to your hips. You can move it closer to your spine itself. No point going onto the bone, stay off the bone. Spend about a minute there. And then last but not least, from this position, you can go ahead and lift your hips up and slide the lacrosse ball or the tennis ball a little further down. It's going to come right underneath your glute. Stay in the top half of the glute to find the piriformis. So you're in the top half, about centered on that glute. And this little muscle can create a lot of fussiness in the hamstrings and the lower back if it's tight and cause your sciatic pain, piriformis syndrome, so it's worth it to spend a little bit of time every day, hopefully loosening it up. You've got about a minute there. Whenever you're ready, you can lift up, and I'll show you how you set up for your hamstring exercise. You're going to go ahead and sit down on the box, and just place that tennis ball right underneath one sitting bone, one side. Yeah, that right leg's good. Once you've found a sweet spot, a little bit of tenderness, you can move the pelvis around a little bit until you get onto something. Just find a nice little lift of the leg up and lower it back down. Flex the foot as you lift and drive right back down with the heel. So once you have moved up and down your hamstring, up and down the back, the line of the hips, the glutes onto your hamstrings, your body will be nice and primed to stretch out some of that junk along the posterior chain that gets tight. We do all of these exercises as a way to prime the back body for the stretching to come.